You've now learned about the abiotic conditions that set the boundaries for ecosystem development and the biotic aspects that determine the formation and resilience of ecosystems. Let us now relate this to coastal engineering design. Suppose wave attenuation and protection against erosion are ecosystem functions that you want to include in your design. The question is how to create an ecosystem that is resilient and able to fulfill the desired functions. A crucial consideration is the size of the desired ecosystem. Ecosystem size should be considered from an engineering perspective as well as from an ecological point of view. The ecosystem should be large enough to sufficiently attenuate wave action. In addition, it must provide enough space for ecological succession and the formation of suitable habitats. This allows development of a stable and resilient ecosystem. Related to ecosystem size is the principle of ecosystem connectivity. Ecosystems are often functionally related. For example, they need to be connected because of early life stages of animals. They develop in one ecosystem while adults of the species live in another. A good example is the nursery function of seagrass beds, which is home to the juveniles of many coral fish species, such as the parrotfish. Without the presence of a healthy seagrass bed, coral reef fishes might not be present to maintain a healthy coral reef. Also, ecosystems need to be able to exchange genetic resources. This gene flow prevents inbreeding, thus contributes to healthy populations. Hence, if connected to, ecosystems become physically separated, or when the necessary connecting ecosystems are absent, the success of ecological engineering may be seriously compromised. You now know what is important for ecosystem development and functioning. Once you have decided what system you want to develop, a first challenge is how to kickstart the formation of the desired ecosystem. You can optimize abiotic conditions and let nature follow with pioneer species and subsequent natural succession. You can also actively introduce such pioneer species yourself. If you opt for the latter, which species should be used? Are the current abiotic and biotic conditions suitable for this species? Let us consider the example of mangrove restoration in Indonesia. In some parts of Indonesia, mangroves were removed to make room for aquaculture ponds. The loss of mangroves, however, resulted in massive land erosion, and total villages were forced to move inland. In addition, the important nursery function of mangroves for several fish species was lost. To restore the mangrove system, it is not possible to simply plant mangroves, as the wave exposure, submersion time, and sediment conditions in the eroded area are not optimal anymore. Planting mangroves is often not preferable, especially if you do not plant the right mangrove species at the right location. This will impair natural mangrove formation and result in a fragile mangrove forest, or no forest at all. In this project, temporary brushwood fences were placed to decrease wave energy and to trap finer sediments. This creates suitable conditions for the establishment of natural pioneer mangrove species. This initiates mangrove ecosystem development through succession. Although challenging, using ecosystems instead of only traditional hydraulic engineering offers additional benefits. Examples are habitat creation for ecologically, economically, or culturally important species, increased water quality by water filtering organisms, and opportunities for recreation. The Building with Nature strategy can also be a solution to mitigate the possible impact of engineering projects. This is especially important in or near areas with habitats protected by legislation, such as the Natura 2000 regulations in the European Union. To summarize, Whenever you are building with nature, it is crucial to consider the local conditions and opportunities, to understand the requirements for the targeted ecosystems, and to understand the services that can be provided by these ecosystems.